Today we're going to be going over my take on a drill press table and a table saw sled, what the benefits are, and why you might want one in your shop. Now these aren't overly flashy, not a lot of bells and whistles like a lot of my other videos, but I think there's still a couple of differences you might find interesting. A drill press table is extremely useful because it's going to give you a lot more surface area when you're drilling those holes. On the smaller factory table, if you have a long piece, it's going to want to naturally teeter on you a little bit, which can be a pain. When you have more surface area, it helps to reduce that. The other nice things are having a fence, having that sacrificial piece so you don't have to have a scrap piece every single time you're drilling a hole, and then also having the T-track so you can hold down small pieces or pieces that may tend to spin on you. We're gonna start off by cutting down all the T-track to size. From there, we'll start on the drill press table, cut the main pieces out, and then cut the dado slots to accept the T-track.
I wanted to be able to use hold downs on both of these projects, but I only had one piece of 48-inch T-track, so I designed both of these to only use that one piece total for both projects. So size-wise, you could easily scale these to be larger if needed. Notice how little was wasted here. A thing of beauty.
All right, the top is mostly ready. Now we just need to cut the pieces to wrap around the existing drill press table. I want this to be as close to a friction fit as possible while still being easy to take on and off.
I need the drill press table to be removable as well because my drill press is a flip top and the table will be too big to fit underneath. That said, when I'm using it, I need it to be secure so I can make repeatable holes and not worry about it moving around.
Now it's time to assemble everything. I'm not sure what kind of torque this is gonna take, so I'm gonna use glue, pin nails, and then throw in some screws just for good measure. Now we need to cut the recess for the sacrificial piece. I'm doing this with a slight bevel, so if the drill bit ever catches it, it doesn't pull it up out of the table and send it spinning around. With that, I will cut a bunch of inserts with that matching angle to go inside. From there, we can start assembling everything together. From there, we need to make the fence, throw on some urethane real quick, put the T-track in and test everything out. The fence is really simple. It's just a small board, two holes, two bolts that go through it to hold it in. I'll add a small chamfer on the bottom side to make sure dust doesn't collect there. So far I like it, but it still moves more than I would like it to. Because of that, I'm gonna have to use some toggle clamps to hold it tightly in place. To make this work, I'm gonna have to make two modifications. First, I have to remove a section of the bottom piece because it's actually in the way. Secondly, the toggle clamps don't quite have the reach that I need, so I'm gonna have to remove the standard bolt they have and add in a longer one. Then it's just a matter of adjusting the tension and we should be in really good shape. All right, now onto the table saw sled. I chose not to go super complex with this because the biggest thing you can do is add stop blocks, and I don't plan on using mine in that fashion. I would use my miter station. I mainly wanted a sled to make small cuts safely as well as making perfect miter joints. The biggest thing with the table saw sled is to make sure that your fences are square. There's a ton of documentation on how the five cut method works. I'm gonna spend less than a minute on it, and then I'll leave a link in the description below of the guy that invented this method, as well as a calculator if you wanna do it yourself. First, let's get the dados cut for the T-track and then get the miter bars attached underneath.
I want the blade to be perfectly centered here, so I set the fence to help ensure that. I put some washers under the rails to make them stick up above the table saw surface so the glue can attach to the underside of the sled. After it dries, we will attach the screws to hold it long term.
Now we need to cut the front and back pieces. I'm gonna add a few curves to this to make it more comfortable to grip and to push my hands further away from the blade. As you go to make your first cut, do not go all the way through. Next, we're gonna use the 5-cut method, which is designed to get the fence perfectly square. I'll do my best to explain this in under a minute. And go.
First, to start, you only attach your back fence with 2 screws, one on each side. Then you start your cuts. After every cut you make, you rotate that fresh edge back onto your fence, then make another cut. By doing this, it magnifies the incorrect angle with each cut you make, therefore making it easier to find what it needs adjusted by. After your 5th cut, mark which is the top and the bottom. Afterwards, you will need 4 measurements. From that 5th piece, you will need the width of the top, the width of the bottom, and the length. You will also need the length of the distance between the 2 screws, as this marks your pivot points. You will then plug those numbers into this formula and then adjust accordingly. If it's a positive number, the fence is too high on the left. If it's negative, the fence is too low on the left. Then use a scrap piece of wood with a point, clamp it down, and use a feeler gauge to help find the gap and the needed adjustment. Then unscrew that side of the fence, adjust where needed, clamp back down, reattach a screw into a new hole, do not use the old one, then repeat the process. This may take a few tries to get it perfect, so don't get discouraged. Here is a quick exaggerated visual of the 5-cut method, so it's easier to see how the angle gets worse each time with the 4 cuts.
Perfect. Now just for good measure, we're gonna add another block to the back just to make sure the sawed blade doesn't come through. Then we'll throw some urethane on the top, throw some paste wax on the bottom to make it move easier, and then put the T-track in. When doing so, it's important to make sure your screws do not pop out the other end or it will scratch the surface of your table saw. Finally, I want to add a jig to cut miters on this sled. Because you'll be able to cut both sides of the miter on this, it's going to ensure a perfect match every single time. In order to use this for things like picture frames, you're going to want to make sure that it can accept longer pieces. Therefore, you're going to want the back fence to be a little bit shorter than the overall sled. That way you can have the pieces extend further. Now I'm going to explain why I think it's worth your time to make sure the back fence is also perfectly square. I found myself to use that fence actually more to make cuts than I have the front fence.
First, because of the hold downs, I don't have to worry about the pieces sliding around. Second, and probably the biggest reason, I don't have to worry about the saw blade coming through and attacking my fingers. Third, I set up this stop block that is easily removable on the table saw and only comes into play when the miter bar reaches them, which is just another fail-safe feature for me, and if it does get in the way, I can remove it with just a screw. Fourth, I find myself leaning over the blade a lot less to see if the cut's completed when using the back fence.
Overall, I love both these projects. I wish I would have made them years ago because they're very useful, very handy. I find myself using them all the time now in the shop, and they were very simple, very easy to make. Now that I know how useful they are, maybe someday when I upgrade to a full-size drill press or my dream table saw, I will make more advanced ones. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did or learned something new, feel free to like the video. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the other videos on my channel. Go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified when new videos come out. here are the projects that are done and just need the videos edited. I'll go ahead and throw up a poll for the next week and see which one you guys want to see. I'm also looking into getting a website up and going that would have plans and other random things that I do around the shop. So if that interests you, let me know in the comments if that's something that you would like to see in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.